Although the details of Hendrix's last day and death are widely disputed, he spent much of September 17, 1970, in London with Monica Danman, the only witness to his final hours. Danman said that she prepared a meal for them at her apartment in the Samarkand Hotel, 22 Lansdowne Crescent, Notting Hill, sometime around 11:18 night, when they shared a bottle of wine. She drove Hendrix to the residence of an acquaintance at approximately 1:45 in the morning, where he remained for about an hour before she picked him up and drove them back to her flat at 3 in the morning. Danman said they talked until around 7 in the morning, when they went to sleep. She awoke around 11 in the morning and found Hendrix breathing, but unconscious and unresponsive. She called for an ambulance at 11:18 in the morning. They arrived on the scene at 11:27 in the morning. Paramedics then transported Hendrix to St. Mary Abbott's Hospital, where a doctor, John Bannister, pronounced him dead at 12:45 in the afternoon on September 18, 1970. To determine the cause of death, coroner Gavin Thurston ordered a post-mortem examination on Hendrix's body, which was performed on September 21 by Professor Robert Donald Tier, a forensic pathologist. Thurston completed the inquest on September 28 and concluded that Hendrix aspirated his own vomit and died of asphyxia while intoxicated with barbiturates. Citing insufficient evidence of the circumstances, he declared an open verdict. Danman later revealed that Hendrix had taken 9 of her prescribed Vespirex sleeping tablets, 18 times the recommended dosage. After Hendrix's body had been embalmed by Desmond Henley, it was flown to Seattle, Washington, on September 29, 1970. After a service at Dunlop Baptist Church on October 1, he was interred at Greenwood Cemetery in Renton, Washington, the location of his mother's grave site. Hendrix's family and friends traveled in 24 limousines, and more than 200 people attended the funeral, including several notable musicians such as Original Experience members Mitch Mitchell and Noel Redding, as well as Miles Davis, John Hammond, and Johnny Winter.